Okay, hi everybody, I'm Pepper, and we're here at NCATS, the National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences. Basically, we're doing tours today for Take Your Child to Work Day, and I'm just showing these guys some of the cool equipment that we use to do our job here. And our job is to try to find medicine in a scientific way, and I've got to show these guys, the cool equipment that we have. One of the things that we get to see today was a compound plate. This is one of a populated compound plates where we're looking at these chemicals to see if they will actually effectively become a medicine or a therapy for some sort of a disease. And so that's basically what we do here. And we use the robotics system to do our experiments for us. The experiments are all devised and validated by the scientists in a separate lab. Once they know that the experiments will work and expect the data that we get from those, we'll bring it over to the robotic system. And the robotic system does a more effective job in doing all of the remainder of the experiment, all the way to data collection. And so that's where we're at. We've sort of shown these guys how the robotic system transports the plates around and all the way down to some of the data that we get. And I'm going to show them that portion of it right now. All right. I'm going to go. So we've done all of the experiment up to where Kelly was showing us how we use a plate reader, and this is one of those types of plate reader. This big piece of equipment that looks like a refrigerator is actually a camera, and this is the image that the camera gets. this mimics the wells of the 1536 well plate, and in each one of those wells was a group of cells in the cell media. We exposed them to the chemical compounds. And then these are the compounds that forced a reaction within those cells. And this information is great as the operator. It will tell us that the experiment is working well, but it doesn't give us a lot of data. It's hard for me to say that this activity and this activity are much different. But what we can do from this picture is we can change it into a numerical value. And the numerical value is very, very easy to analyze, and we can change. We can gather all of that data, and within a very narrow range of numbers, we can pull out the compounds that we found that were effective in whatever it was that we were looking to address. And so we can cut and paste these into a database. The database, we can run those through an algorithm that says, take out if you had numbers from 1 to 10, and all we wanted to see was numbers that matched 5, 6, and 7. Well, it could take out all of those numbers and the locations of those compounds and put those into another database, and then we can do further experiments. Okay? And we're going to come down here, and you guys can see better the robotic arms that we use and sort of how they pick up the plates and they move them from station to station. And so the furthest one away is for the compound library, and that pulls the plates out of the compound carousels, brings it down to do the pinning. The second arm is going to control the assay plates, so the plates with cells in them. It'll take it to the pin tool, and then it brings it back to the incubator if that's what needs to be done. And then the third arm will pick that plate up from a hotel, and that will bring it to one of the readers. The reading is done. That process, that experiment is pretty much done, and then it goes into the data collection and the data analysis part. Cool? All right, does anybody have any questions that I can answer for you? Sure.
I've always been curious, why such massive robots in terms of energy efficiency?
Okay.
You picture these working on automobiles or something.
Well, that's exactly.
You have a little plate.
So. Okay, so the question is why do we have such large robotic arms to move a small 2 or 3 ounce plastic plate? And the reason is because at the time that these systems were made, these were the most effective and efficient arms, robotic arms that were available, and they had enough reach to reach out to the individual stations and put those plates and pick those plates from those locations. There were no small form factor arms that would work effectively and do the same job. And you're right, these arms are the exact same arms that you would see making cars. They call it light duty industrial automation. And these can pick up hundreds of pounds if necessary, but they can also pick up 3 ounces, and they pick it up from the same spot that they put it to every single time with very high precision. Okay, does anybody else have any questions? No? Okay.
I got another one for you.
All right.
We have a quarry right here in town that explodes dynamite
okay.
every Tuesday, Thursday around noon.
Okay.
Does that affect the calibration?
Okay, so the question is the seismic activity, man-made or not, affect the position of the arms? Directly, I would say maybe. There will be some settling of the equipment over time no matter what. They do come out of adjustment slightly over time, partly mechanically, because as they wear, they change their position ever so slightly. But also, you know, the platforms that they arm settle a little bit, the ground settles a little bit, but they're high precision and they hold their adjustment pretty well. But that's, you know, my basic job here is to at least in part help to maintain them, make adjustments as they come out of adjustment, that type of thing. Cool. Anything else? No? All right, well, if you guys are ready to go do the experiment, we're gonna head out there and you guys can have fun to do that. Cool? Okay.
How come sometimes they're staying still?
Because they're waiting for the next activity to start. So this one has brought the plate over to the reader. And so it's waiting for the reader to be done doing its job, and then it will pick it up and it will take it back and give it to the other arm.
Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. The basic idea of what we're trying to do is to further research in many disease models, cancer, rare neglected diseases, using old archaic drugs that are no longer used as they were originally intended. We found that they actually can work on some of these diseases they were never studied to affect. The reason we use a robotic system is because there are so many compounds, there are so many potential experiments that can be done. It's extremely difficult to do it with people. So these robots are doing all of these tedious tasks. They're also doing it much more efficiently. It records every move that it makes. It records every time it puts compound into a well in the plate. It records every time it dispenses liquid to a well, and it knows exactly where it did it, when it did it, how much it did, and so we have traceability that way. We know if there is potentially a failure, that we can trace that back, and we know where, how to correct it. I have heard that the number of experiments that have been done on this robot, it would take a legion of people 20 years to do or something. It's
Wow.
Astronomical number. So the well plates that we use have 1,536 wells. So each one of those is an individual experiment. And if you had to do that in a larger vessel, for lack of a better way to describe it, there's the much less efficient. And so that's why we use the robotic systems and we use that format to do those experiments.
That's awesome. And someone just asked how long it takes to train someone to use these.
Well, that's a great question. So there are most of the people that have been working on this system, that has been something that they've done for their entire career. Mechanical engineer, biomedical engineers. We have super users, so there is one person that controls how the robot is used, and they'll typically have one or two people that help them to do the maintenance, to do the loading the system, and then programming the robot to do that particular experiment. Sure. So, don't know exactly how to finish it up, but this is amazing work that we do here, and you know, our mission is to really just help everybody, hopefully find you know, medicines, and that's it.